Today, I'm going to show you how to make a vector or vortex spiral using various different techniques and systems within Adobe Illustrator. It's pretty intricate, so follow along. Also, making today's video possible is a really good friend of the channel, and that is Template Monster. I've shown their awesome selection of templates and other resources for graphic designers before, but they've actually expanded their website and they've got a whole lot to offer, especially they've got a Black Friday sale with up to 50% off all of their items until December 3rd. So for our vortex design, we need a pattern, and so first grab the pen tool by pressing P on your keyboard. And then just make one part or one section of a continuation of a pattern, as you can see I'm doing here. I've got the smart grids activated by pressing Command or Control U, and that helps everything stay perfectly in line with these magenta lines you can see on my screen. Now, as you can see, my pen tool path doesn't actually line up properly at the bottom here, and to adjust that, all we need to do is to open up the stroke window and then change the line to a projecting cap. And then things will be perfectly, you know, in line in terms of the actual color stroke itself. So after you've made adjustments and you're perfectly okay with your line for the pattern, we're now going to make a new brush. So come up to this option here and select new brush. And we're going to be using a pattern brush for today's design. By default, things should probably be okay, but just play around with the settings if you want to, and we're not going to be using any curved or any cornered lines. This is going to be one continuous straight line. So the next step for our vortex pattern is to make one straight line with the pen tool by holding down Shift on your keyboard, then press V to select the line itself, then come into your brushes menu and simply just click the brush that we've just made. And there you have it, you have a continuation pattern, and as you can see on my design, mine isn't completely joined because I'm kind of rushing this tutorial, to be honest, but just make sure before you make your brush that things are connected properly. But the next step is to outline the stroke of this line, because it's not actually a vector shape at this point, it's still a stroke, so we need to outline the stroke. Then hold down the Alt or the Option key, as well as Shift, and then click and drag down below, just ever so slightly. This is going to make a duplication, and then you press Command or Control D to repeat the process to fill up the page with the pattern design. So the last step in this part of the tutorial is to open up the symbols window, because we're going to make a new symbol by actually grouping together all of these shapes. So press Command or Control G to group your shapes together, and then just drag and drop them into the symbols window, and you've created the symbol which will make up our vortex pattern, which I'm going to show you how to do right now. Now, there are different ways to make a quarter of a circle, but the way I'm going to show you is pretty quick. Just press L for the ellipse tool, hold down Shift and make a circle. Then grab the pen tool, and with the smart guides activated, make sure your pen tool is completely perfectly in line with the center. And then using Shift, just head over to the center and then down, and then make a shape that goes around. Now, once you've done that, select both shapes and open up the Pathfinder window and use the intersect option, which will leave you with a quarter of a circle. Some of you might be thinking, where is this going and how does this create a vortex? Well, you soon are going to see just how to make that vortex. So we need to come up to Effects, 3D, and then Revolve. Make sure to hit the preview button and drag around your shape until you feel happy with the kind of vortex design that you want to see for your own graphic design project. If you come into the Map Art option, we then can actually drop in our spiral pattern. And you need to make sure it fills up the whole of the canvas to fill up the entire vortex sphere. And for now, we're actually going to use the invisible geometry part of this option here. But later, this is going to be turned back on. But for now, we need to leave it like this, invisible. So there's the vortex, but we need to actually add some color to it and to make it look more realistic. So grab the pen tool and using a stroke, carefully place positioned anchor points like I'm doing here. There's no need to make curvatures, but because I've got a really nifty technique to show you that will make a perfectly generated circle around our design. Simply using the ellipse tool won't fit the shape of our design properly. So once you have made the points around the shape, hold down the command or the control key, you can actually curvature the vector path in between those anchor points. And also you can stretch out the handles too. You want to be as precise as possible when doing this, and this brings me on to the next tip, which is to actually head into the appearance panel and then select your shape, your design. And we're going to head back into that 3D revolve vector that we made. Click the preview option again and then come back into the map art section. And then uncheck the invisible geometry option. So by using the command or the control function, you can really make a perfectly aligned vector path around your design. And it does have to be as precise as possible because we're going to use a clipper mask later, which will finish off the design. So once you have that circle finished, press Command or Control X to flick it over to a fill instead of a stroke. And then select everything, and then right or control click and create a clipper mask. And there you have your vector vortex design, which you can actually clean up and you can add some more shadow effects into the middle and center if you want to. But as I mentioned, sponsoring today's video is Template Monster, where you can actually pick up to 50% off all of their products until December the 3rd on their Black Friday sale. As you can see here, prices are slashed across the board. And for us graphic designers, there's quite a lot on offer in terms of PSD templates, illustrations, icon sets, but I'm specifically fond of the font section because I love typography and there's quite a lot of fonts to pick and choose from. And coming into the font section, you can see the prices have all been slashed right down, and that's really awesome. And remember, that is only until December the 3rd. But if you check out this font here, you can see that it's down to $9. But there's also the option of getting it for free if you have a one membership, which I'm going to tell you about very, very soon. Also, I found that Template Monster has a very good customer help service where you can start a chat with the staff member right here. Now, Template Monster have launched a new service, which is called The One, and you can get that from around $13 a month, billed annually, and it opens up the doors to every single download on Template Monster for free, as well as other perks such as 24/7 support, unlimited installations, plugins, and so much more. There really is a lot to offer when you do go and join up for The One membership, so do check it out, link down below. And remember to join in on that Black Friday sale ending on December the 23rd. But until next time guys, make sure to have a great day and do design your future today. Peace.